Hi all! Everything in my videos is pulled from the public domain and I'm using them under the fair use guidelines. Everything I say is my own opinion. You should look into this information yourself, but I'm pretty sure I'm right. So I wrote something on Twitter and a Twitter war started where, as usual, the sugars called me a racist and a bigot. You guys all know the drill. However, there was one user who asked me why I didn't like Megan. She wanted proof of what I was telling her, so I thought, can I actually see into the mind of a sugar? So I pointed out some various lies and things that she has done that calls her character into question, and here's what happened. So first I pointed out that she lied on video about there being no tabloids in the United States, and here's the actual video.
I'm sure he's great, but you shouldn't do it because the British tabloids will destroy your life. And I very naively, I'm American, we don't have that there. What are you talking about?
So when I pointed out that she had lied on video about there being no tabloids, the sugar's response was, and I'm quoting, she didn't say the U.S. doesn't have tabloids. She said she's never been involved in tabloid culture when she lived there. And I reminded her that that's not what the video says at all. And then she stated, quote, in the U.S., they don't have mainstream newspapers that run tabloid lives. They are more like magazines and so, and not factual newspapers, close quote. What I heard was a bunch of word salad. And once again, an excuse for what she said. Then I pointed out that she had stated she paid for her own education, which came out later to be a lie. Here's the actual video.
The challenges of being able to afford this level of schooling for many people around the world, myself included. It was through scholarships, financial aid programs, and work study, where my earnings from a job on campus went directly towards my tuition, that I was able to attend university. And without question, it was worth every effort.
When I pointed out to this sugar that Megan had blatantly lied about paying for her own education, her response was to say, and I'm quoting again, she was explaining to Fiji students who didn't have enough funds. I don't think it made sense for her to start going on about her dad winning a lottery to them. She had to relate to their struggles, close quote. In other words, they're giving her a pass for the lie she told. Why didn't Megan simply say that she had help from her father, but it wasn't enough and she had to supplement? Why lie? Then, of course, I pointed out that Harry was trying to get Megan work while at the Disney premiere of The Lion King in July of 2019. He was caught on camera touting her to the head of Disney. Here's the video. Now, the sugar's response to this was to say, and I'm quoting, they had already done the Disney gig a year before the Lion King premiere, close quote. Which is correct, as the Elephant movie was released April 3rd of 2020, and per all online information, including Vanity Fair, the documentary was recorded in London in the fall of 2019. But this sugar also insisted that the voiceover work was done 3 years earlier in 2017. But the fact of the matter is, Harry would not have had to ask for voiceover work from Disney if she'd already done the voiceover work. But the real reason people were upset was because Harry, who was Captain General of the Royal Marines at the time, missed a memorial to honor victims of an IRA bombing to go tout his wife to Disney. So this man is now upset that he has lost his military titles because he thought it was more important to try to get his wife work than to honor his military obligations. In a final effort, just to show this sugar how I felt about Megan's character and her constant lying, and that the problem is her character and not her color, I showed her the things you now see going across your screen. The sugar's response was to say, quote, that's where you get your information, Quora and the Daily Mail. I'll get you a reply to all the allegations with factual proof, though, close quote. And then she sent me a page from the Sussex Squad and stated, quote, the owner has done her research and compiled it on the page. You will see accurate facts and references there, close quote. So to be fair, I clicked on the link she sent and was flabbergasted. It was all word salad about how the media was secondary sources, they're grabbing at straws, it's all propaganda. Don't doubt Harry and Meghan. There was nothing. No examples of behavior or lies were addressed anywhere on this page. I had also pointed out to this sugar that there was a recent lie where Meghan said she didn't know that the UK had a Black History Month, despite her writing letters to students at a primary school where they wrote to her for a Black History Month project. I explained that usually where there's smoke, there's fire. Reports of her setting up pap shots, being mean to staff, which is why they lost, what, 5-6 aides and 3 nannies in a very short amount of time. Meghan's diva-like behavior at Wimbledon, where she cleared out all the seats around her. She didn't say anything or even try to dispute that Meghan announced her pregnancy at Eugenie's wedding, which is a major social gaffe, or that Meghan is constantly plagiarizing. But in the end, she simply said to me, quote, "I don't have time to try to convince you. You just go on hating her," close quote. And it just goes to show that in the minds of the sugars, Meghan can do no wrong. She gets a pass for all of her lies and wrongdoings simply because she's biracial. And when I pointed out again that my dislike was due to her character and not her color, I was met with indignation. So what I'm hoping is that when you get out there and make your statements about them and you're called a racist or a bigot, in an attempt to get you to silence yourself and not speak, do what Meghan says. Find your voice and keep going. I hope you guys have a great day.